everyone, my name is Lisa Ann, and today we'll be talking how to win your audience with storytelling. Storytelling. So, it has the power to transform your business. And today, we'll explore the science behind why stories are so powerful, the presence of storytelling as a trend in marketing, and how you can start using the power of storytelling today within your business to achieve better results. I actually bet you'll be shocked when you learn just how our brains process stories in compared to facts, and how this actually affects consumer behavior, in turn, how it affects your business results. So let's do this. People have been storytelling for ages. I don't know about you, but my version of storytelling when I was growing up is when I was with a group of people up north at my parents' boat at the fire and hearing my parents' friends telling us haunted ghost stories so we wouldn't sleep at night. Storytelling was a concept that was originally saved for the arts, for things such as songs or books or plays or movies. And now in the world of marketing, especially digital marketing, storytelling, it wasn't a concept that was widely emphasized until Y2K. And actually in the last 20 years, marketing has become incredibly sophisticated. It's pretty cool. Let's first dive into the science of storytelling, but don't you worry, I am far, far from a science geek. I'm just gonna break down the basics, the facts that I personally thought were interesting to see where we've come from to now how I actually use it with marketing. So here I go. In the book called Actual Minds, Possible Worlds, they listed some research that showed messages delivered as stories can actually be 22 times more memorable than just sharing facts. 22 times is huge. But why exactly is that? It turns out that stories make us use our brains differently, and that is why they're so effective in getting people to actually act. Experiments, they also shows that when listening to a story, we tend to get lost in a feeling that actually makes you favor that story a little bit more, which comes down to us feeling like we know that person or that we're literally talking on their emotional level. But to simplify it, we're a lot more willing to consider what is being shared with us when we're in a frame of mind, when we're trying to picture that situation or scenario for ourselves. Stories require us to use our brain. That's as simple as it is. We no longer process simple factual information. Facts are something that can just be absorbed. We don't need to give them much thought, but stories, on the other hand, they're abstract in nature. They require us to become immersed in it fully in order to understand it completely. And when our single focus is on that story, we are much less likely to deconstruct or really just delve that information that's being provided with you. And that's the science of why stories are so powerful. I know I told you very basic, but they almost have this hypnotic effect on it. Picture a fisherman reeling in his hook, okay? That's what stories do to us. They reel us in. Stories are also helpful because they act as a memory aid for us. Now, this also works with acronyms or songs, by the way. You just continuously remember them. But since stories are so elaborate and exciting, they are actually a really easy way to tap into someone's emotions. Which brings me to tapping into their emotions for your audience and how we can actually use that for your marketing. Now, back in 2009, Simon Sinek, in his TED Talk, How Great Leaders Inspire Actions, started a movement. And that movement changed marketing forever. In his speech, he talked about a pretty significant people in history. He talked about Martin Luther King Jr., the most influential leader in the civil rights movement. He talked about Steve Jobs, the creator of Apple, and I know I don't have to tell you, Apple is huge. And the Wright brothers, the two Americans who have the credit for inventing, building, and flying the world's first successful airplane. But what we can call storytelling, Simon refers to as your why. In fact, he actually published a book called Start With Why, which I highly, highly recommend. I have it in my bookshelf over there. That one word though, why, it suddenly became this fuel in everyone's engine. After Simon, everybody wanted to talk about their why. It didn't matter if you were selling bagels or running a politician campaign. Storytelling in the world of business, it really just became the norm. It became the trend. Businesses don't just want to sell you something. They actually wanted to connect with you. And boy, was that ever odd. Think about that. Go back a long time ago. How odd is it that people want to connect with you now? Marketing has evolved, and I'm sure you've noticed that. It's no longer enough just to advertise your products in the forms of, my product's the best one, I won this award, they do this, they do that, they do this, all these amazing features. That is not gonna cut it anymore. People of this age have higher expectations and they're really no longer looking for that information or the solutions. They are looking for connection, and that is why social media is huge. People can connect worldwide. So the first thing is this, our image of storytelling, it might be different from when you're a kid. If your version is like mine, sitting around that fire, I'm not saying that you have to forget that version of storytelling, but I am going to point out that storytelling isn't just for bedtime and it's not just for campfires. It's a broad concept that can be applied to literally everything. It can move consumers, it can move countries. It is such a powerful tool. So when you think of storytelling, I want you to remember this. Close your eyes for a minute. Picture yourself and your loved ones and you're going down a farmer's market. It's a beautiful, sunny morning. You know, those mornings where it's not too hot, but it's warm enough that you're comfortable, but you're not dripping in sweat. It was literally just perfect out. Not a cloud in the sky. Can you picture it? You walk in and you see a lemonade stand. The redhead girl, she's mentioning that they just won the best lemonade stand for the last 2 years. You glanced at it, you're looking at it, but you're not really thirsty just yet, so you kind of just keep on walking. 10 minutes later, you see a crowd of people around a little stand. There's this older gentleman. He looks about late 80s, early 90s. He's wearing his cute little golf outfit. He's telling the crowd that him and his wife started their lemonade stand when they retired to keep busy. He mentioned how it turned into so much fun that it actually brought a spark back into their lives and into their relationship. It's so cute. He then actually mentioned how he had to miss last season because unfortunately his wife passed. And he started going into how he just couldn't stand to do the lemonade stand alone. But there he was, sitting at his lemonade stand 1 year later. He said that this is the first day that he's been out, and it's been really, really hard, but it also has brought him this sense of happiness. I don't know about you, but I am buying that lemonade. He sold me, and I didn't even know he sold lemonade. I didn't know what flavor he sold. I didn't know anything. I'm telling you, it is so powerful when you use storytelling in your business. Plus, it really does take the selling out of selling. So if you're someone who hates selling, this is for you. And if you follow Gary Vee, storytelling is certainly one of the things that he pushes. In fact, in 2007, he was a keynote speaker for a conference for Adobe. And his speech was, "Stop storytelling like it's 2007. Gary Vee, he knows the power of storytelling, but he also believes that people need to master storytelling in micro moments, is what he says. In his words, we live in an ad culture where people are not overloaded with information, but they're also very short on time. Well, that may be true to a certain extent, but some of us still find time to sit through a 2-hour movie or watch an entire season of their favorite show on a Sunday afternoon. People's attention isn't so much the issue. The concern is actually the content. And by the way, how you tell stories on one platform will be totally different on another platform. Because remember, each social media platform is actually used differently. And actually, Gary Vee said it best when he said this, and I'm gonna read it and quote it for you. When you are on Facebook, that's all encompassing around awareness, around your social graph. When you're on Pinterest, your psychology is intent to buy or aspiration to buy. You need to be storytelling differently on those platforms. You have to be giving them different visuals that are mapped to the psychology, not to the numbers of users that there are. but to reverse and engineer why they are here. That's the key with social media. Remember, tell them why they are there. But just remember, storytelling is powerful, and it's something I want you to start paying more attention to. But before I move on to the how, let's do a quick recap on what I just taught you, okay? I don't want to lose you. So far, you have learned that storytelling and marketing, it motivates customers. It makes you memorable. It strengthens relationships. Think back to that, the lemonade stand. And it makes your content more exciting because it creates neurological associations. That memory aid, remember that. Now you've also learned that how you storytell will be different on every single platform. So choose which one you'll focus on and don't try to master everything all at once, okay? Focus on one piece at a time. Now, if you're new to storytelling, don't you stress. It's not as hard as you're making it out to be. Especially, it's not as hard because this is a natural thing that we all do now. But there are actually a few different types of stories that we can tell. If it's an educational story, a big idea story, a motivational story, a how-to story, just to name a few. There's so many different types of stories that you can do. But what I find is that every effective story will actually have 7 main pieces to it. There's always, always a point about overcoming that monster. There's the rebirth stage, the quest, the journey and the return, the rags to riches, a tragedy, and then there's usually comedy. Now, I'm not gonna get into all 7 different aspects in this training, but if you do wanna learn more about any of those, or even what they mean, make sure to leave me a comment below this video and tell me your top 3 that interest you most, because I will get into them for you in future videos. But before I end this, let's get into something that we should consider when crafting our stories. Now, typical questions that I ask myself and that you should be able to answer are these. So write these all down. First one, what is your message? Who is your key audience? Where is the story happening? Who is the hero? What is the challenge? What has actually happened? Was there something that unexpectedly happened? What questions will you pose to your audience to start to make them think about it? And what is the call to action? Guys, call to actions are key. And a few tips is to be authentic, be vulnerable, inspire. Now also include a twist. It's something that always just looks good, that hook to grab that attention. And unless you're writing a book, keep it simple. Less is more with stories. But it's also important to make sure that the story is easy to understand. Just as there are things to include, there's also some things that I want you to avoid. So let me start with saying you don't need to make yourself or your brand the star of your story every single time. You do not need to be that hero. Share about other people's stories, your clients, your customers, your friends, your family, share. But also make sure you don't provide too much information that gets you off track and really just gets you way off the story. And also with your stories, you don't only want to show your successes. We are human, we fall down. Your failures or struggles are lessons for others. And lastly, something most don't think about is the final point. After you told your story, what was the point of it? Share that, add in a conclusion. That way they know the story is done. And remember, storytelling really is an art. For some people, this comes naturally, and others it won't. You may be one of those people that needs to work on it, and that's okay. As long as what you end up with is a good story that in some way, somehow motivates or moves the people that you're trying to go after, you're off to a great start. Stories are powerful because of how much they get into our head. So take advantage of that power and push your business in a positive direction through storytelling. And of course, if you do have any questions or simply just don't trust yourself to do this alone, feel free to reach out to me. I'm always here to help. And as always, if you learned something new today, hit that like button, be sure to subscribe for more marketing content, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye for now.